If you look at the structure of vitamin D, it is very similar to the structure of cortisol, of the structure of testosterone, of estrogen, of progesterone. And what do we know about all of these other steroid hormones? They go directly into the nucleus of the cell where they affect transcription of protein factors. And depending on the cell type, it's going to have a different effect. So already right off the bat, you can see that vitamin D is doing something very different than what we would think of as just a vitamin where you need a cofactor to have an enzyme do A to B. It's much more nuanced than that. And very early on, the studies on vitamin D were involving calcium, bone metabolism. And so they came up with all of these things because they didn't know what else vitamin D did, really. I mean, they had some idea, but they came up with these standards. Oh, you need so much vitamin D for your bones to do whatever it needs to do in the calcium. And so the analogy I like to use is like, you know, you're baking something, right? And you put so much flour into the recipe. It's as if to say that's the only thing that flour is good for is this one recipe. And that if you use flour for anything else, that's exactly the amount of flour that you'd have to use for any other recipe. Well, that's nonsense, of course. I mean, we know that we need a certain amount of vitamin D for proper bone metabolism. But why does that carry that that's the amount of vitamin D we need for a proper immune function? I mean, none of those things are there. And we have all of these standards about how much we need. We'll talk a little bit about the observational studies. But vitamin D is not just a vitamin. It literally falls more into hormonal. I mean, think about Addison's disease. Addison's disease is where you have antibodies that attack the adrenal gland. It's this tiny little gland that sits on top of your kidneys. The purpose of that adrenal gland is to make cortisol, aldosterone, androgens. These things are essential. In fact, if people lose their adrenal glands, they'll die. Because they don't have enough cortisol. Cortisol is essential for just the regular running of the body. And here we have this thing called vitamin D. The problem is we don't have a gland that makes vitamin D. We have the skin, right? So the skin through the sun and ultraviolet B radiation, which barely penetrates through the epidermis, it gets down to the dermis where the actual starting product is. And so if you don't get enough of this, you are going to be lacking in a whole host of things.